you guys, Brandosaurus Rex here, and today we're going to be doing a review on the NECA 1985 Godzilla figure. And the reason why I call it the 85 Godzilla is because that's what it says on the box. I don't want to stray from what it says on the box. I know it's the 84 movie that came out in Japan, but in America it came out in 85, so that's what they dubbed it for the American figure. That makes sense. So without further review, let's take a look at the box. I don't have the box at the moment. This is not my figure, this is my brother's figure, just to skim through this briefly. And I'm just gonna put a photo of the box right here. Bam, there's the box, looking really cool. And not much to it, just a window display box. And that's basically it. So now let's take a look at the figure and its accessories. For accessories, Godzilla 85 comes with exactly this. Everything that you see here. I guess you could count his tail as an accessory since it's not technically attached to the figure. It has been said before, but some hot water on the tail and, you know, just to heat up the plastic and, you know, just a quick pop on will get the tail to pop on for those who are having issues popping on the tail. I had to do this for my brother because he was having a hard time popping it in and did not want to break the figure as well, because NECA figures are known for breaking. So, moving on. So quickly, I want to talk about the paint and sculpt of this figure. And there is a lot, and I mean a lot, to be desired in this figure. I feel like when they redid the figure, because this figure had a terrible head sculpt, and there were so many fans that were complaining about the figure and, you know, speaking badly about NECA and their products, I did not like the figure from the get. And I just feel like this figure still has the same problems that I saw in the prototypes that I'm seeing now. And honestly, the head wasn't the only problem for me. The arms look weird, the legs look weird, and the tail is skinny and small. I honestly don't like this figure. And I've said it, and for all those people who, you know, who like this figure and think it's worth the $20, that's good for you. But for me, there is a lot to be desired in this figure. The sculpt is poorly done. The head is spot on. The head is the only thing that they got right on this figure to me. The paint is really sloppy on this figure too. Like, I'm gonna show you some instances where I just feel like there could have been changes made that would have just made this figure so much better. Looking here at the feet of the figure, you can see that there is chips of paint just coming right off of this figure. And I haven't even used this figure. I've literally taken it from my brother's house, put it in a bag, and brought it to my house. And there's paint missing from the feet. And then there's extra paint of the bone texture, like, you know, nail color, that's on the foot all the way up to here. There's little splotches of paint on it. This is just weird. I don't know how they got this so wrong. And then over here, this toenail is just incredibly long. How did you miss this when it went into production? How did you not see that toenail was just way too long? As a sculptor, you think a sculptor would notice that nail was just so long. And this is on every figure that I've seen so far. That bothers me. Another thing that I want to just rant and rave about this figure is the arms. The arms bother me to no end. I'm so frustrated thinking about this because I don't know who sculpted this, and I've heard somebody say if it was a first-time sculptor who made this, and I really am starting to wonder, now that I have this figure in hand, who the hell sculpted this and how did they still have a job? Because if you look at this Godzilla, his arms look like somebody who's folded up their sleeves and is ready to do some hard laboring. Once you put this arm down, and this becomes a major problem for me, this roll of fat that's just sitting there just stays there, and it just looks weird. It doesn't move and flow naturally. It just looks like Godzilla has some giant tumor in his arms. It doesn't look like muscle or arm, like an arm to me. It doesn't look like a Godzilla arm. And then the forearm is just one straight long line to these really oddly posed hands. They're just like, there's no emotion or no feeling of a Godzilla in it. It's just hands that are dangling. It just doesn't look, it doesn't scream Godzilla to me. This screams average monster movie, B-movie stuff, like a guy in a suit which is not what you want to project in a figure. You want to project Godzilla the monster, and that is a giant failure in this figure's part. Another huge problem that I have with this figure is the thigh articulation. The thigh articulation is something to be desired. Yes, this figure has a great range of motion and articulation in the thighs, but once you start to pose it and you get into it, this just looks terrible. Why would you sculpt it in such a round fashion when you know it has to meet up with this? He gives him great birthing hips, so I hope Godzilla's popping out babies, because he'd be great for popping out babies, but this just looks terrible. Who got away with this? They did it so perfectly well on the 2014 and also the 94 figure. How did you mess this one up? How do you get two right and then this one you just completely just give up? You're like, the customer's just gonna buy it anyway. This is terribly done, and this is a poor excuse for a great leg swivel. And here we have the dorsal plates on the back, and this bothers me even more. They're tiny little dorsal plates. I'm gonna grab the 94 NECA-Godzilla and I'm gonna compare the scales so you could see how tiny these scales are. So here we have the dorsal plates lined up from both figures, and you can see that the 94 got it right with these very large scales, and they're painted greatly. But what is this poor slob job that's just slapped on here? Look at the paint bleeding through, just on all parts of the black. There's just white poking out. And then some of these dorsal plates, even up here, not even painted. And then the sides are not even painted. It's just the tips of this that is painted. And then the sides, they just said, screw it. The fans wouldn't mind. Then going into the tail of this figure, they completely just missed. You just missed it. I don't know what that is. This is just terrible. If this was my figure, I would definitely want my money back. Then right here, a whole scale, just not painted. It's just black. This giant gap here is just terrible. I'm just gonna take this out. It's just, how are there all these things that has to go through product lines and all of this, and you can't even just get this right at all? So for articulation, this figure has a good range of articulation. I'm not gonna say anything bad about the articulation. I think the only real problem with the articulation comes in the legs. So for the mouth, it opens and closes. It's on a very strong hinge, by the way. And you can move it from the top ever so slightly. Not really. Oh, you actually can spin it all the way around. That's cool. And then it also has a joint at the base of the neck. The arms can go about that far out. Not very far. Can rotate. Also, there is a elbow swivel combo thing. Then the wrists are articulated and they are on a ball peg, it looks like. Is that a ball peg? Yep, it's on a ball peg. A great range of motion here on the, I don't even know if that's his waist or abdomen, because it's just so poorly sculpted. But you don't want to articulate this too much, because if you start rubbing this together, the paint's just going to come off of the dorsal plates. And I don't want to ruin this figure for my brother, because this is not my figure. Again, then the legs can rotate all the way that far back and that far forward. And then he also has a knee bend, which goes about that far, not too far. And he has the weakest foot articulation I've ever seen ever. And then the tail, there is four points of articulation. And then you get into this really tiny piece of crap that's just hanging on there with a bendy wire, which I hate bendy wire so much. So for size comparison, here is the 85 Godzilla compared to NECA's 94 Godzilla. And you could see that they are kind of the exact same height once you start to finagle the legs and fix them. So here is the 85 figure compared to the Rebirth High Side Godzilla. And you could see that these figures work in scale together. You can get this to work. But honestly, I really wouldn't want this to work. I want the SH Monster Arts brand, Bandai, Tamashii Nations, to make their own 84 Godzilla. So I'd never have to buy this. So for my final thoughts, I think you guys pretty much have it summed up. I do not like this figure. I think a lot of people gave the 2014 Godzilla a lot of crap for being a poorly constructed, a poorly painted figure, I would say. But this figure is getting way too much praise. And I mean that. This figure is not good by any means and any standards. I do not like this figure. I do not recommend this figure. Do not buy this. It is not worth the $20. You're better off buying the Hi-Sai figure from NECA's line, because that is a better made figure. Or saving your money and buying the 2014 SH Monster Arts or the Rebirth Godzilla, because those figures are worth every penny. This figure is not. I highly suggest skipping this figure. It is a piece of crap. So with that being said, take a look at the other videos that are shown at the end slate that is made by Neverfolded Films. Shout out to them. Come check us out on the ACBA Facebook page, and you know, come join us. Come add me on Facebook and all my social media down below. Click one of those links to see one of my older reviews, and I'll check you guys out next time. Peace out, nerds. Don't buy this figure.